What up, Pittsburgh Steelers fans? The Steelers have picked their first round pick. They stuck and picked, or sticked and picked, and they picked Troy Fatanu. That is Troy Fatanu out of Washington, an all versatile offensive lineman, can play technically all five spots. Not really a center guy though. Be interesting to see if the Steelers do potentially play him there. He actually was a left tackle in college, played predominantly left tackle. So whether he's going to play left or shift to the right, that's an interesting question with Broderick Jones. The guy's only played two snaps his entire college career at right tackle. No snaps at center, no snaps at right guard. 100 snaps at left guard, over 2,000 snaps at left tackle. He's only allowed three sacks his entire college career. Two of them were this past season, but Washington did go across through to the college football playoff, the ultimate championship game. He only allowed 5 quarterback hits in his college career, 3 this year, 2 last year, 35 hurries overall in his college career. He allowed 43 pressures. Really, really experienced player with the over 2,000 snaps, played over 949 snaps the last 2 years running, just shy of 1,000 snaps last year. He's such an athletic tackle, which is probably why the Steelers picked him, that in early in the draft process, Rhett Lewis on the Move the Sticks podcast actually said Troy Fatanu, you could even draft him as a tight end, as a big blocking tight end, or have a reason, even if you had starting bookend tackles, to draft him in the first round because of the swing tackle and the opportunities that he offers. Now, some of the weaknesses out on him is that he can sometimes suffers against longer opponents who can break through his blocks. His run blocking technique can sometimes get away from him. That's why maybe shifting to the right would be good, because we know Broderick Jones is an experienced run blocker. He can sometimes be a bit slow with his hands, or they're incorrectly placed. So they're things that he's going to have to work on. But he can work into the center. He can get to the second left level. He's got good knee bend, good lateral quickness, according to Lance Zierlein of NFL.com. So all those things are very, very positive out of him as well. The other thing about Troy Fatanu, his pass blocking grade is very, very high. One of the highest of all the tackle prospects coming out in this year's NFL draft. He was also very, very consistent. All his PFF grades are pretty much over 80 for an 80% of the games that he played in this year. So that's from a blocking perspective. So that's actually really good. You don't want to see fluctuations too much. Steelers have gone there early. There are a lot of center prospects still going to be available in round 2 in Frazier, Cedric Van Pran, JP Jackson Powers Johnson could be there. I'm disappointed. I didn't want to see Graham Barton picked potentially by the Steelers. Probably not likely to happen. If you manage to get him and Troy Fatanu, you'd be absolutely laughing. But he's a versatile player, can play in at guard if you had to kick him in, or if there's a tackle prospect the Steelers might like next year. So all in all, you can't argue with the pick of Troy Fatanu to the Pittsburgh Steelers. He's from the Huskies program. They've won a lot of football games. He allowed Penix time and space to throw. We saw how high Penix was taken in round 1, pick 8 overall of the Atlanta Falcons. That doesn't happen without Troy Fatanu. And hey, Roger Rosegarten, his teammate on the other side who played very well, he could be a future late pick for the Steelers, and then you can play Fatanu when it's center or guard. We will see what the Pittsburgh Steelers want to do. I did feel like he probably fell to the Steelers in this position, but at one point it looked like Fuaga might be available on the board. It is interesting, though. They have neglected to pick Quinyon Mitchell or Terry Arnold, who was still available. Those still guys sit there. Maybe you see the Steelers trade back in to get Joey Porter Jr.'s partner. But cornerback is very deep, so it makes sense. Troy Fatanu, welcome to the Pittsburgh Steelers. We'll be back for all the rounds and reaction as we go through our lives on day 2 and day 3. Our reaction video live will be available shortly on the channel. But as always, go Steelers.